there's an enormous body of knowledge in biology and ecology, zoology and biochemistry. And yet those people who are studying how life works very rarely talk to the people who now are trying to design our world in a way that works better. Okay, the designers and the engineers. The work that I'm trying to do right now is simply to create a flow structure between these two worlds so that the ideas from biology can flow and inform human flow into and inform human systems design. That's the real work right now, is to get those two disciplines to share best practices, right? Especially the ideas going from biology into engineering and design. And so some of the ways that we're working on doing that is literally to have biologists at the design table. I mean, if you had to describe what is biomimicry, it's inviting nature to the design table. And so a biologist comes to the design table representing nature's best ideas, life's genius. And so, and it's very exciting. There's now in the charrette process or the ideation process in companies, some of the companies that really want to try this biomimicry method will have biologists come in and say they're designing a desalination plant, okay? A new way to desalinate water. Now we use, you know, 900 pounds per square inch of pressure pushing it through a membrane that often clogs. It's very energy intensive, our desalination processes. So in that case, a biologist would begin to talk about the way life sequesters salt and recovers fresh water, you know, and there's many examples. So they would talk about mangrove roots. Mangroves, you know, live with their roots in salt water, but they survive on fresh water. In fact, all the organisms that you see, fish and everything that you see in salt water, is surviving on fresh water. So there's desalination going on. So all the membranes, all the filter feeders that you see in the natural world, okay? The nasal glands of seabirds, our own kidneys, our own cell membranes. There's mass, just to have a biologist at the design table talking about how nature purifies water. It's groundbreaking because it's done in ways. For instance, the mangrove certainly doesn't use 900 pounds per square inch. It's a solar desalination device, you know. So there's that, training biologists to be at the design table. Then there's also, you know, in the moment of creation, wouldn't it be great, in lieu of having a biologist sitting right with you, wouldn't it be great to be able to go to the web and type in filtration in a saline environment, okay? And up comes pictures of mangroves, or up comes pictures of the nasal glands of seabirds. So that's another thing we're working on, is a gigantic tool that takes filters through the biological literature, which is massive, but it looks for function, okay? So how does nature create color? How does nature play with light? How does nature lubricate? How does nature adhere? How does nature communicate? How does nature upcycle all of its materials?